Right, good afternoon once again. Kailan ko muna po? Ako kawin yung ha, para I'm your cameraman for this selfie number 15. Because of this, I made a very difficult and tough decision in my whole life. Because just this morning, I received a phone call coming from unknown numbers and unknown individuals and offer me something. Offer me something, and it really bothers me a lot. I think for this a couple of hours, and then I made a decision to turn down the offer. Just for two reasons. First, this selfie 15 is still ongoing, and the second is, I'm one of the speakers this afternoon. And the offer was to replace the cameraman of Ang Provincial. Just kidding. May naman ako ang madaan, bakit niya, kasi makatulong mo, niya, matalo mo ka rin, nangatawa na mo ba, niya, kung kabalo mo siya yung katawa, dahil kayo pinaan mo. Okay, good afternoon. My topic for today is pain and guidance. Bro Elbert told me, bro, you have 2 hours for your talk. Mas baga-baga yan yun. Kung bro, pwede, we extend up of 30 minutes. Is it 30 minutes? So, siya, bro, the floor is yours. So, okay lang, mga 2 hours na din. Okay lang naman, but since it is Sunday today, and tomorrow is a busy day for us, I will, imuha ko niya siya 30 minutes. Believe me, 30 minutes na rin ha. Then, ako sa i-check.
Start now.
Check na lang po ha. Then, discussion starters. Discussion starters. Manili lago na eh, ako nalang napi ng dala. Inyo ha, manili. So, ang akawali is, 4 pages already, sumakaya, like in 30 minutes, sabi niya, Roger, pala yung Roger rin, nadala ka ng kapil, bro. By the way, bro, John, bro, Reg is a member of mine. I am very proud of my members because they are fresh. They are fresh from CLP number 14. And look where they are now. Bro, John and Sis Karen, they're sitting in the secretariat, as an assistant secretariat. Sis Sheila, future and assumed assistant secretariat, Onea. Si Javier Corbol, bro. Bro Linis, sitting in the table number 7, as an assistant discussion leader. Sis May is in the number 3, assistant. Karon, siya po ng leader, kaya wala si Sis May. And also, si Sela, sus mga energetic kaya sila mga namin bro. Si Lee as a assistant of my queen. Assistant is actually. And bro, Richie. I saw bro Richie kanina, bro, katapat-tapat siya ni bro Arvin. Basing na ngayon siya mga idea about siya, which ay trabawa sa AMD. Bro, I am very proud of them and I know that someday they will proud of their leader too because their leader will lead this chapter. Joke na to ha, kasi ninyo tinun ko. Okay. Okay, pain and guidance. Okay. Someone once compared the Christian life to swimming in a river. You can never stop swimming because once you stop, you're being swept away by the current. We have given our life to the Lord and have been baptized in the Holy Spirit. that is the beginning of our life as a follower of Christ. In order to become a regular in our prayer, we need to become regular in our prayer. Here in PCBP again, we are required to do it every 15 minutes. And we have to study our Bible or scriptures 15 minutes also. We also need to deepen our faith in the Lord and learn how to recognize what the PCBP is all about and what God wants of circumstances of our life. Swimming is very special in my life. Special in Canada because throughout, because of my faith in the Lord, He guides me to the top. Because when I was still in college, I am one of the four representative in our department, the physical therapy department during exams. There are four because in swimming there are four strokes, and I am the butterfly. So because of that, the four medals, the three medals, the bronze, the silver, and gold, I got it in swimming. Wala ka kayo mga kamay? So when Brodnik challenged us palumbay tapkat sa lubing, ayun din ko nung kaya siya na ako ay will challenge you in swimming. Okay. Growing in faith. God wants to work through us because He wants us to have an expectant faith. Faith is the way in which we need God to enter into our lives and allow Him to work through us. In 1 John chapter 4, verse 4, He who is in you is greater than who is in the world. So if Jesus Christ is in your heart, or in your, within in you, wala mo yung aking kahadlukan, di ba? Wala mo yung aking kabalakan, because siya man ang nasa inyo, kasing-kasi, siya man ang nasa inyo. He works through you. And the other way, imo mo siya i-surrender ang imo hang life kay Jesus. So wala siya kay angay kabalaan kay di ba po ka mabuhat o mga dautan kay gigayin man ka ni Jesus. In Ephesians chapter 3 verse 20 to 31, now to Him who by the power at work within us is able to do far more abundantly than all that we ask or think. To Him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus for all generations. So we need to honor our church. We need to praise our God. Bisamun saan, bisa pag atong mga anak, kinanan, i-honor, kabalo ni sila mo praise and honor sa atong God. Because these days, to all generations. God works in us through faith. Not because He wants us to make it hard for us and give us an obstacles to get through. He wants us to rely on Him, to work for or through us. Faith opens up and makes it easier to receive from God. Finally, faith allows us to use what God gives us. Faith as understood here is not just a doctrinal faith, believing in the doctrines of the church, like the divinity of Christ. It is not just trust in God's goodness either. It means believing in God's word, expecting it to come through, and acting on it. We can call this type of faith as expectant faith. A good example of it is Peter walking in the water. So, kabalo mo sa story ni Peter na walks sa water. So, please allow me to share to you, no? So, anaa sila sa tunga sa dagat. Yes, si Jesus, wala si Jesus sa aning atay, kadira yung mga disciples. Because Jesus is in the mountain praying. So after these 4 days na sila nasa kuana sa middle of the sea, nagbagyo na siya, na-store sugay ang hangin, waves, pusugayo, and then the disciples, nakulbaan sila, nahadlok sila sa nahitabukan sa strong waves, sa bagyo. And then, this Lord Jesus coming, and you think that it is only an apparition? So nahadlokin sila. So when Jesus, well, na si Jesus, he says to his disciple, "Do not be afraid, it is I." So Peter said, "Lord, if it is you, command me to go over you." And then Jesus said, "Come." Then suddenly, immediately Peter, he announced his boat, and then he walked for a few steps. Tungod sa kapusog sa hangin sa bandog, nahadlok siya, and then he began to sink. And then Jesus said, "How little your faith is, how little your faith is." So Peter said, "Lord, save me." And then Jesus extended his arm to Peter, and then he asked Peter, "Why you doubt?" So this is the story of Peter walking on water. Growing in faith. God wants to work through us through faith. Speak that faith. Faith is not a blind leap. It is a response to God's revelation. In Luke chapter 11, verse 13, "If you then, who are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more the Heavenly Father will give His Holy Spirit to those who ask." So, kanto bisa kanto mga basta mga evil, to mga person, evil person, mangawa sila, buwan sila kautan para lang sa ilahang mga sa ilahang pamilya or sa ilahang mga anak, how much more the Heavenly Father, ihalo na ihatag, tanan ng inyong pangayon, even the Holy Spirit. In 1 John chapter 9, chapter 1 verse 9, "If we confess our sins, He is faithful and just. He will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness." So nindot kayo, no? So kung mag-umpisa kita, dili lang kayo i-forgive niya ang ato ang sins, iyaha patang hinluan. Iyaha patang hinluan sa maayo. So nindot kayo, so kita ka na lang, umpisa man ta, so maayo dito itong ibuhat. A woman told me, na kanakuno ako mabito mga kanatong mga loved ones na namatay, dili daw na nato sila may hilakan yung gayo. Dili daw nato na sila kagunan because na kanatong mga loved ones nga namatay, pag-abot nila sa langit, ang ilahang buhato na na is only singing, dancing, and praising God. So, nalipay na ipiyan na sila dito. So, kinahalan din na kinahalan sila kabalahan din na tarangay niya mag-uol na paanan nila kay nanan na sila sa mayang kahimta. So, if my time comes and Jesus want me to His kingdom, din niya po ma-hadlok o din niya po ma-balahan. You know why? Because I can sing and I can dance. Remember, muna ilang buhato dito. Praising, the sing, the dance, yung gina sila. So, ano mo malakan mo? Kabalo mo po, anak. Diba? So, kato mga participants na din ikabalo mo sa'yo, din ikabalo mo kanta, pag-practice din mo, kaya kasi pag-abot dito, kasi pag-play sila mo ba? But Jesus guides you here in BCBP. Because here in BCBP, every time we gather, we sing. And there are four events in a year na kinahalin kita manayo. Whether you like it or not. First, in your commitment day, kinahalin yung manayo. So, kabalo po, nagkuhanan mo sa inyong hasayo. Second, in the chapter anniversary. Third, in Christmas party, kinahalin kita manayo. And fourth, during our NAC celebration, National Anniversary Celebration, manayang gidyakon tayo. So, kanyang mga BCBP members, may na kayo sila manayaw. Kami, may na kayo manayaw. Bisag ka ng mga doctors, bisag, una-una ninyo mga doctors, mga papuan kayo sila, pero pasayawa na. Grabe na manayaw. Speaking of sayo, pakimbot lang sa ito ang sa lubot, Bro Daddy is the man. Bro Daddy is the man. Pingin na siya masaya yun. So, John 3:16, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whoever believes in Him should not perish, but have the eternal life. So, muna siya ang evidence, muna siya ang nagpatunay nga bukin ang eternal life, manipayo na kaya itong mga loved ones ito. Ako, alam mo, yung mga mama, papa, at first, sakit yung isa ako, pero na kapupon.
Nanayan sila, bro.
It is a response to God's revelation. It is a response to revelation about situation, discernment, or leadings. God's will becomes clear in a certain situation, whether or not to take a certain job, or whether or not to move to Canada with a family. Once it is clear what God's will in such situation, we can act on a discernment and expect that faith of God's support. A response to what we know about the Lord. For example, we read in New Testament about Jesus healing the woman in a hemorrhage. So, katong napuli siya ang story ni woman ito na nahihimoris na siya sakit na nagpa siya nagawa sa dugo sa iyahang now. But because of his faith and her faith to Jesus Christ, bisa na po no, pagkibado niya na Jesus is in their place, niyadugidan siya, pero kapurong na siya kay tungkol sa maulaw sa iyahang now, kapurong siya, pero niyadugid siya kay tungkol gusto siya na ma-heal. So because of his faith, even kung matouch na niya ang cloth ni Jesus, maayaw din siya. So he or she touched the cloth of Jesus and then na-heal na tayo siya. And then Jesus noticed that the power is nigawa sa iya. So ni kwade siya, ni tanaw din siya kung kinsa itong ni-touch na iya. And he saw a woman, pero nagkurong-kurong ito ang bayan yung tungkol na hadlok mo siya. And then he asked Peter, who touches me? And then Peter said, sa kadalhan ng tao, nakaibalo at nakapatikol pagiging ka nga na nag-touch sa iyo, it is because iyahang na-feel nga na inigawas niya power sa iya. Butong na-heal po dahil na ang babae. And Jesus said to the woman, because of your faith, you heal. So ang imuha magtuon, muna ay nakaayo sa iyo ma. We also have Jesus Christ is a good physician. Siya ay good healer. You can see ka na si Dr. Jema, si Dr. Ayans, si Kata, sunod na na sila kagpahal ni Jesus. Si Dr. Polayaku eh, sunod-sunod na na sila. Si Dr. Jema. Okay, expectant faith is fundamentally a response to God Himself that comes from hearing truth about Him in believing. In Galatians chapter 3, verse 2, Paul writes, let me ask only this. Did you receive the Spirit, the works of the law, or by hearing with faith? in faith. Of course, be part of the BCBT community. The most important way is to be part of the environment of faith. In other words, become a member of the BCBT. There, you have been surrounded by many brothers and sisters who responded to the Lord through faith. So kung gusto mo upuan, kanidiri sa BCBT, naamot yung mga BCBT brothers and sisters na who grow really mature in the life, in the Christian life. Kung gusto mo na makawarunuan sa inyo ha, about the Christian life, ato lang mo sa balay. Ewan na tamo yung sister yan. Na bro Erwin. Eh, kasi kung pula ko ba? You know what? There's a study that shows that says that if you really want to look young, to look beautiful, to erase your wrinkles, eliminate your wrinkles, ayaw pagbutangan ng mga ipagbutang ipakaptizing now. Ang inyong buhatong is tanaw lang ang mga movie na katawanan, kahit yung books na katawanan ko, or you can read me. Red P na lang, Red P. Kapangin mo ninyo, eh, matukos ninyo balay, katawag na mo. Marato na, inyong 1,000 ang pay. Tara, be part of the BCBT community. Read the scriptures with faith. So, ako ang ini, mag-study kita sa ato ang Bible. Again, 15 minutes. In my case, as a physical therapist ng God, so our mga pasyente, dili kayo ni time, lagi may time, di ba? Lagi may apply na tens or electric stimulator for 20 minutes, yun na siya. So after that, because gusto niyo kumubasa sa akong Bible, na ruban ko up sa ako ang cellphone. So during that time, ako gigi-scroll na ako ang cellphone, nabasa ko sa verse. Paul writes, so faith comes from what is heard. What is heard comes by the preaching of Christ. Read the books that build faith, beginning with the Bible itself. Practice praying and acting in faith. Mission ka ganina is if dili magin mo kabalo mo kung sa pray, ato lang yun i-follow from acts, which is adoration, confession, thanksgiving, and supplications. Don't try to work up feelings of faith. That makes us focus on ourselves, when what we need to do is focus on Christ, His power and His promises. When you pray for things, do not beg, but rather pray with confidence, thanking God for what He will do, confessing His lordship and power, praising Him. A very good way to realize how God really answers our prayer is kung mabanta niya mag-pray, natin ipangayon niya, isulat nato siya sa notebook. Sulat nato siya sa notebook, tapos ato siya magtangan ng dates kung sa imuhang ipangayon. And then, after a month, imuna siya tanaw. Yeah, matingala ka na gatoy mo ang mga prayers o mga imuhang ipangayon na answers niya. Wala lang ang kabado. In Mark chapter 9, verse 24, I believe, help my unbelief. And the second part of my talk is guidance, or knowing God's will. If we truly love the Lord, we desire to surrender our will to Him. John chapter 14 verse 19, if someone truly loves me, if someone truly loves me, he will keep my word, and my Father will love him. Another verse in John, I will not leave you, orphans, I will come to you. And in Psalm chapter 32 verse 8, I will instruct you and teach you the way you should go, and I will counsel you with my eye open. So dili kita biyahan si Ginoo, no? Isa mo sa itong problema, naahina siya. Counsel you with my eye upon you. So, tanan na itong mga problema, ako agad dapat na siya i-counsel sa Ginoo. Kay wala hindi na yung i-masagdan. Remember the footprints in the sand? Footprints in the sand, the story is, there's a man dreaming that he is walking along the beach with the Lord. He noticed that there are two footprints in the sand, and during this time, pwede sa iyahang mga happy moments. So, naiyahan na notice nga na two footprints in the sand. One belongs to him, and the other to the Lord. And plus in his life, na ako'y pagtanaw niya, isa na ka footprints in the sand. And during this time, it is during his lowest and saddest time. So he asked the Lord, Lord, you said that when I decide to follow you, you will be nakasakwa given sa tanan panahon. But why is it that during my lowest and saddest time, I saw that there's only one footprint in the sand? So the Lord answered, my son, my precious son, I love you and I would never leave you. During the times of your saddest, lowest time, that you notice that there's only one set of footprints in the sand, it was then I hear you. So nindot niya siya, no? So tanan ang mga problema na agit si Jesus. You know what? Every time I hear these footprints in the sand, or every time I hear this in the song, maglibaw ang pinakabalayin mo, especially the letter part, the end part yun. Maglibaw ang pinakabalayin mo, anak. Gusto ko mahila, but for me, boys, don't cry. Dali kayo mga tawa, no? Hindi kayo mga tawa, kita kung muda kanta, ang mawala sa tuwa is cholesterol. Pero kung mga tawa, ang mawala sa tuwa is ito ang mga wrinkles. See? Kasi, magpamahuli ninyo, may ganun nyo ang mga anak, ang mga family members niya. Hala, di ba talaga kayo bigwa pa ma? It is wrinkles. Sige, nagkatawa. Tanawa ko. Di ba? Kumorti na mag-celebrate ko sa akong 48th birthday this year. Wala na. Because I am a happy person. And there are so many reasons why I must be happy. First, God loves me. Second, God created me and gave me this. God created me and gave me this good looking. Gwapo na mo. Pero may iba ka na iba ka type sa gwapo. Gwapo periya gaba. Gwapo periya buyag. Kamu na iba alam asa kung ninyo butan na ito. But remember, Jesus created me. Siya kung ninyo may butan dito sa periya gaba. Third, a fourth, I have a wonderful family na aking mga children. Na loving children. Four, ha?
Four pa.
Fifth, ako'y asawa ng guwapo. Butan! Na ako'y asawa ng guwapo. Ako din yan. So? Inanan. Happy to get home. Ano naman tawagan mo? Do you have something to say about my wife? Ito, kung to all the girls I love you for sharing and being pakasada. And they inform you, we have celebrated. to the instructor. Thank you, thank you. Bapak. In John chapter 14, verse 15 to 17, if you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will bring the Father, and he will give you another counselor to be with you forever, even the spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. You know him, for he dwells with you and will be in you. So this is the Holy Spirit. Kapalo ba rin mo kinsa siya? Kita ba rin mo niya? Wala. Pero, naibalong siya, naibalong ka Holy Spirit yun na siya. E tumulat na aman siya kanat, na aman siya sa ato ka. The way God guides us. God teaches us either through study, especially the scripture, or Christian tradition, or the Christians, or experience. About the scripture we read in 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 3 verse 16 to 17. All scripture is inspired by God and is useful for teaching, because Jesus Christ is a great teacher. No, kabalo kita teacher ni siya. Singa great teacher ni siya, singa na sis is italani. For fruit. So, kung nanakot, kung gadaw, kung yun sa paghimo sa Ginoo ang kalimutan, so, ibasahan ninyo sa Genesis. Sa Genesis, dito yun may iba ka ng tanan. Sa reproof niya, in Genesis chapter 1, verse 3, dito niya gihimo ang light. No? Okay. Paghimo niya sa earth, ragitkit pa kayo sa gibuatan niya o light. And day, it becomes a day and night. For correction and for training in righteousness, so that everyone who belongs to God may be proficient, equipped for every good work. Now, kung si God sa'yo, sumubuhat ikaw mga maayong mga buluhaton. For most things, we do not need specific guidance. If you want eternal life, keep the commandments. Matthew chapter 19, verse 17. How are we guided? Through the general directions of our lives, the commitment we have if we are married, God wants us to live our marriage commitments as a husband, as a wife, and parent faithfully. Or if we take BCBP as a member, because we have a commitment card, inahalang ito ato ito siya ipalo. The challenge that needs that face us, if we have a growing family and the children are of school age, we know that we need to provide for them in good way and care for our livelihood. How he has worked with us spiritually over the years. Example, if I go over my life, I can see how God has led me to the breakfast, to the BCLP, to the BIS, and to the BCBP, etc. By specific guidance, whether by circumstances or leadings or signs. If we think we are getting specific guidance from the Lord, we always need discernment. It is easy to confuse our emotion and desires with the voice of the Lord. Circumstances could be an obstacle to overcome, as well as indication of His will. A person has been out of a job for quite some time and can seek to find a work. This obviously is a great difficulty, an obstacle. It could also be an indication that the Lord wants that individual and his family to seek work elsewhere. We need to grow in discernment between our impulses and God's leading. We should be careful about how we speak about receiving guidance from the Lord. It is good never to say, "The Lord told me to do this," but instead, "This is the will of the Lord for me." for it has been properly deserved. Pay specific guidance that is mediated. Counsel through pastors, mature Christians, parents. In Proverbs chapter 12, verse 15, the way of a fool is right in his own eyes, but a wise man listen to advice. Through the authority we under, but we beseech you, brothers and sisters, to respect those who live among you and are over you in the Lord, and admonish you and esteem them very highly in the love because of their work. Be at peace among yourselves. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 12 to 13. How to grow in guidance and discernment. Pray and seek God's guidance. So, na-pray ta, inalangin ta mga yung guidance sa itong Ginoo. Study the Holy Bibles. Study the Scriptures. Meditate in your own experience. Talk decisions over with others. So talk decisions over with others. Example, sa mga pari, na itong mga elders diri. Example, sa line na religion, na kung sila yung mga pastors. So, kinalangin ka makintok sa mga sa laing tao. In Psalm chapter 40, verse 8 says, I delight to do your will, O my God. Nalipay ko Ginoo sa pagbuhat sa imuhang gusto. Nalipay ko Ginoo sa pagbuhat sa imuhang gusto as a priest, as a nun, or as a BCBP member. So, kaya siya, pagbuhat niya na sa Ginoo nga, gikain kita niya pagulong niri para ma-grow pa ang atuang spiritual life. We need to trust the Lord and His desires to reveal His will to us. We should not be over-anxious to get it right, just right. We need to be patient if we are new in a committed Christian life. If we have just finished the BCLP, it will take us time to grow into a mature understanding of God's will for our life.
Problem, kailangan natin na marami na agad sa atuwa.
Kanya ato ang nakita, and we see that the only solution that we see is to kill ourselves. Brothers and sisters, call to Him. Ask forgiveness. Believe Him. Trust Him. Knock at His head and knock at His heart. Have faith in Him. And I'm sure you will be guided. We have no right to kill ourselves. We have no right to take away the lives of others. Because, as what Gary Valenciano song says, ang buhay mo ay